Hello students, so this is the fourth lecture of capacitance and capacitor, and in this lecture we will see first the spherical capacitor and then the cylindrical capacitor. Okay, we had already done about that parallel plate capacitor. Okay, its formula, its capacitance formula we had already seen, that is C equal to K epsilon 0 A by D. Okay, so now we will see the spherical capacitor. Okay, so the first thing, this part we had already done, that means the spherical conductor is there, okay, and it is charged with suppose positive charge, okay, and the amount of charge is suppose Q, okay, radius of this conductor is R, then capacitance of this conductor equal to 4 pi epsilon 0 R, this thing we had already done, right? Right, here one plate is this and another plate is at infinity. Okay, infinity means potential is zero, and here there is some potential, that is Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R. Potential difference will be Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R minus 0. Okay, so you will get Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R, and then capacitance equal to this. Clear? Clear. Now we will take two conductors, two spherical conductors, concentric spherical conductors, and one of them is grounded. Okay, so suppose this is the diagram, so suppose this and this, okay, two conductors, two concentric spherical conductors are there. Okay, radius of the inner one is suppose R1 and outer one is suppose R2. Okay, and outer one is grounded. Clear? Outer one is grounded, and on the inner surface the charge is Q, suppose it is positively charged. Okay, clear? 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 So due to this positive charge, due to this positive charge, the negative charge will induce on the inner surface of the outer sphere, right? Inner surface of the outer sphere, that means here minus minus. Okay, and its value will also be same with Q. Okay, that means this charge, this negative charge will be minus Q. Okay, and outer part is grounded. Okay, grounded means there will be no charge. Okay, no positive charge will be there on the outer part, and as it is grounded, so it will be zero potential. Okay, the outer sphere will be at zero potential because it is grounded. Clear? Clear? So we have to find the potential difference between these two conductors, then we will find the capacitance. Clear? So first we will find the potential on the inner sphere. Okay, so V, suppose I am giving name V1. Okay, V1 will be what? Due to plus Q. Okay, and then plus due to minus Q. Okay, due to this plus Q, the potential on this surface will be Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R1, and due to this charge, minus Q charge, this surface is the inside surface, and the potential will be plus minus Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R2. Okay, here we have to consider plus minus sign because it is potential. So take Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 common, it will be 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Okay, do the LCM, you will get Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R2 minus R1 by R1 R2. Clear? This is the potential on the inner surface. And potential on the outer surface is zero. Take it V2, okay? It is zero. So change in potential, suppose V equal to V1 minus V2, change in potential. V2 is zero, so this will be the only value. So Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R2 minus R1 by R1 R2. Clear? Clear? Okay, so now we will find the capacitance. Capacitance means C equal to Q by V, right? C equal to Q by V. So Q by V. So first do cross multiplication. So it will be 4 pi epsilon 0 V equal to Q into R2 minus R1 by R1 R2. Clear? Clear? Now Q by V, take V there and this part will come here. That means R1 R2 will go up, R2 minus R1 will come down. So Q by V at the end, Q by V will be what? R1 minus R2 will go up. So 4 pi epsilon 0 R1 R2 by R2 minus R1. Clear? Now this Q by V is what? Q by V means C. Okay? Q by V means C. That is 4 pi epsilon 0 R1 R2 by R2 minus R1. This is the capacitance. When the outer sphere is grounded. Clear? Outer sphere is grounded and some charge is given on the inner sphere. Clear? Some charge is given on the inner sphere and outer surface is grounded, then capacitance will be this. Okay? So here again you can check that the capacitance of any conductor or of any capacitor does not depend on the charge, does not depend on the potential difference, depend on the shape and size and depend on the medium. Clear? Clear? So this is when outer surface is out. Okay, now second case a little bit complicated. Second case, this is inside sphere, this is outside sphere, they are concentric sphere. Okay, now the inside sphere is arced. Okay, inside sphere is arced. Inside sphere is arced. Okay, and some charge is given to the outside sphere. Suppose Q amount of charge is given. Okay, and you can take it as positive. Okay, clear? Clear? Okay. So if this is the situation, then what will happen? What will happen among this charge, this Q charge? Some amount of charge will go to the inside surface of the outside sphere. Inside surface of the outside sphere. So suppose that charge is Q prime. Okay. Suppose that charge is Q prime. Okay. Now what will be the amount of charge on the outer surface? That will be Q minus Q prime. Clear? Q minus Q prime. Clear? Clear? And due to this positive charge, the negative charge will be induced on the inner sphere. Negative charge will be induced. Okay? Negative charge will be induced and it will be minus Q prime. Clear? Minus Q prime. Clear? Clear? Okay. Now look at this case. Okay? This capacitor is a combination of two capacitors. Okay? How? How? So first I am taking these two, that means this negative charge and this positive charge. They are equal amount of charge, Q prime, okay. So it is a combination of two, so first one is this, okay. Inside sphere minus Q prime and inside surface of the outside sphere, that is plus Q prime, okay. They will make a capacitor, minus charge, plus charge, equal amount of plus minus, okay. They both are the conductors, so they will make one capacitor, radius R1 and outer radius R2. Okay. R1, R2. Okay. Clear? Plus another capacitor that is made by the discharge, means the charge residing on the outer surface of outer sphere. Okay. Outer surface of outer sphere. That is plus how much charge? How much charge? That is Q minus Q prime. Clear? Here radius is only R2. Okay. Now how will you combine them? How will you combine them? There are two kind of combination. That is series and parallel. That we will do in the next class. Okay. So I am just giving one hint that how will you do that? look at this conductor, the outside conductor. Okay, one part I have taken, that is positively charged, and another part that is also positively charged. That means this part, these two part of two different capacitor is connected at a same point, right? For that reason this is positive and this is also positive. Clear? So whenever two terminals of same charge, two terminals of same nature of charge are connected at a particular point, then that kind of combination is known as parallel combination. Clear? Parallel combination. And in parallel combination, the formula is C will be C1 plus C. Simple addition. Okay. Suppose the capacitance of this setup is C1 and this setup is C2. Then C will be C1 plus C. Simply. Okay. Clear? Clear. So here C will be capacitance due to these two conductor of charge Q prime. Okay. Plus the capacitance due to this conductor of charge Q minus Q prime. Clear? This is a spherical capacitor, simple spherical capacitor. Okay. And this is the combination. So it will be 4 pi epsilon 0, that is C1. C1 will be 4 pi epsilon 0 R1 R2 by R2 minus R1. Clear? This thing we had already done in few minutes back. Okay, C equal to 4 pi epsilon 0 R1 R2 by R2 minus R1 plus. Now C2, what about C2? C2 is direct 4 pi epsilon 0 R2. This is the direct spherical capacitor. Okay, 4 pi epsilon 0 R2. It will only depend on the radius of the conductor. Right? Now add them. So 4 pi epsilon 0 common. Now R2 minus R1. So it will be R1 R2 plus R2 into this. Right? So R2 square minus R1 R2. Clear? So this cancelled out. So it will be 4 pi epsilon 0 R2 square by R2 minus R1. Clear? So this is the capacitance. When this will happen? When the inside sphere is grounded. Okay? Inside sphere is grounded. Okay? Now question is, this is the capacitance. Okay, now the question is, how much charge will be induced on the inside sphere? How much charge will be induced on the inside sphere? So as it is grounded, so potential will be zero. Clear? As it is grounded, so potential will be zero. Okay, so this is the capacitance. Clear, everyone? Okay, I am erasing this part. So potential on the inside sphere will be zero because it is grounded. Okay, so V inside sphere equal to zero. Clear. Now potential at this surface will be produced due to its charge minus Q prime, this charge plus Q prime, and this charge Q minus Q prime. Okay, so I am writing, look at this. So first of all, due to this minus charge, so it will be minus k q prime by radius, that is R1. Clear? Then plus k q prime by R2. Okay? Then this charge, outside charge, plus k q minus q prime by R2, that will be zero. Clear? So now these two and these three, okay, minus k q prime by R1 plus k q prime by R2 plus k q by R2 minus k q prime by R2 equal to zero. These two terms cancel out. Okay. So k q prime by R1 equal to k q by R2. Okay. K cancelled out. Okay. So q prime will be R1 by R2 into q. Okay. Q prime will be R1 minus R2 into q. So what will be the induced charge on the inner surface? That is R1 by R2 into Q. Okay, nature will be negative. Nature is negative. Okay, I am not finding the nature here. Nature will be negative, that you have to understand. I am finding the value using this relation. Value is Q prime equal to R1 by R2 into Q. Okay, we have already taken the negative sign here, that means nature will be negative. Clear? So this is the amount of induced charge on the inner sphere. Clear? Clear? Okay. So now we will see the cylindrical capacitor. Cylindrical capacitor. Okay. Cylindrical means it will look like a cylinder. Okay. So two cylinder will take. This is the inside one. And this is the outside one. Okay. Two cylinders. Okay. Their axis is one. This is the axis of both the cylinders. This is the axis. Okay. And outer cylinder is grounded. Outer cylinder is grounded. Clear? Clear? On the inner cylinder, I have kept some charge. Suppose it is positive charge. Okay, positive charge. And the amount of charge is Q. Okay. So, on this surface, that means inside surface of the outside cylinder, inside surface of the outside cylinder will be induced minus Q charge, right? That will be, this is minus negative, okay, negative. So, negative Q amount of charge will be induced on the inside surface of the outside cylinder. Clear? Take their radius. Inside one is R1 and outside one is R2. Okay? And their length is suppose L. Clear? Clear? So, first of all, this is grounded, means outside cylinder is at zero potential. Okay? So, I am taking V2. V2 equal to zero. Outside cylinder is at zero potential. Okay? Now, first of all, we will find the electric field intensity at any inside points. Okay? At any points. Here, 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 anywhere. Okay? How will you calculate? You will calculate using Gauss theorem. Okay? That you had already done using Gauss theorem. If you use Gauss theorem, then the electric field intensity E at any inside point will be what? That will be lambda by 2 pi epsilon 0 r. Okay? R is what? R is the distance from the axis. Suppose this. R is the distance from the axis. Okay? So, you can look at your copy. You will get E equal to lambda by 2 pi epsilon 0 r. Now, lambda what? Lambda is charge per unit length. So, Q by 2 pi epsilon 0 r l. Clear? Q by L means lambda. Okay? Okay. Now we have to find the potential difference. Okay? And at the end C equal to Q by V, charge by potential difference, we will get the capacitance. Clear? So, potential V, okay, potential difference between these two conductors, cylindrical conductors, potential difference will be what? Will be what? Integration dV. Okay? From this point to this point, outside point to inside point. That means 0 to suppose V. Okay? That is V2 equal to 0. Okay? So, outside cylinder is at 0 potential and inside cylinder suppose at potential V. So, potential difference will be V. Now, what is the formula of dV? dV equal to minus EdR. Right? Minus EdR. So, minus integration EdR. Okay, this was the potential limit. Now, dr limit we have to take. R limit is what? That means R2 to R1. R2 to R1. Clear? Clear? Now, put the value of E. Put the value of E. You will get Q 2 pi epsilon 0 L. These are constant. So, minus Q by 2 pi epsilon 0 L. This is constant. 1 by R is the only variable term. That is dr by r, r2 to r1. Clear? Clear? Now do the integration. What will be the integration of dr by r? What will be the integration of dx by x? dx by x means what? Dx by x means ln x. Ln x. Ln mean log with base e. Okay, exponential. So it will be ln r. So it will be minus q by 2 pi epsilon 0 l ln r. Okay. Lower limit r2, upper limit r1. Okay. Now put the limits. Put the limits. First r1 minus r2. Okay. So it will be r1 minus ln r2. Okay. If it is minus sign, log something minus log something minus. Then how will you can express this? Division form. Ln r1 by r2. Right. Like this. Ln a minus ln b. So it will be ln a by b. Okay. So here r1 by r2. So ln r1 by r2. Okay. Now r1 by r2. R1 is smaller. R2 is greater. So r1 by r2 will be a fraction. Right. R1 by r2 will be a fraction. Means less than 1. Okay. R1 by r2. R1 by R2 will be less than 1. Less than 1. If you take log, then R1 by R2, it will be less than 0. Okay? It will be less than 0. Less than 1 means, if you take log, then it will be less than 0. That means negative. How will you can it positive? So, if you interchange their place, that means minus ln R2 by R1, then this part will be positive, right? If you interchange them, R2 up, R1 down, then R2 minus R1 will be greater than 1, okay? Log greater than 1 means positive, okay? So here, the same thing we will do, just interchange them. If you interchange them, R1 by R2, if you write it R2 by R1, then from this part, the minus sign will vanish, okay? So it will be R2. 2 by R1. Clear? 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 Okay. So, this is V. V equal to this. Okay. So, we got the potential value. Now, use this thing. Q by V. Okay. You will get the capacitance. So, I am erasing this part. So, first, cross multiply 2 pi epsilon 0 L into V. 2 pi epsilon 0 L into V will be Q ln R2 by R1. Okay. Then Q by V. Q by V. So Q by V. Q by V. Then this part will come down. Okay. 2 pi epsilon 0 L by ln R2 by R1. Clear? Now Q by V equal to what? Q by V equal to what? Q by V equal to C. So C equal to this. This is capacitance. This is the capacitance formula for cylindrical capacitor. Clear? This is the capacitance form of cylindrical capacitor. So here again you will see that C depends on L, R2, R1. That means it depends on shape and size again. And epsilon is present here, that means it depends on the surrounding medium. Okay. If the medium is not free space, then we will put 2 pi k epsilon 0. Clear? Clear? So these are the parts about the cylindrical capacitor and spherical capacitor. Okay. Now I am telling one two points, very important points. Okay. That is, I am erasing this part first. Okay, so that is an important point. We know about the parallel plate capacitor, right? Parallel plate capacitor, we know. Here plus charge, here minus charge, okay? And if it is plus Q, it is minus Q. Separation between them is D and area of the plate is A. Then C will be epsilon 0 A by D. If the there is no medium in between the plates. If there is medium, then it will be K epsilon 0 by D. Clear? Clear? Now, the overlapping region of the two plates is A. Okay? Overlapping region is A. Okay? Now, suppose first of all this was like this, okay, overlapping region in filling. Now I am sliding the plates, okay, one is going in this direction, another is coming in this direction, okay, or one is fixed, another is sliding in this direction or in this direction. Then what will happen? Then the overlapping area is decreasing. Clear? Overlapping area is decreasing. Look at this. Okay. If I remove like this, then the overlapping region is decreasing. Okay. Like this. Overlapping region is decreasing. Clear? If overlapping area is decreased, then capacitance will decrease. Okay. That means if the plates are slides, if the plates are sliding on one another, okay, then overlapping area decreases and hence the capacitance also decreases. Clear? This is a very very important point. If the plate slides, then overlapping area decreases and hence the capacitance also decreases, because this area here A, this is the overlapping area. Okay, this is the overlapping area, overlapping of two plates. Clear? So this is our topic, spherical capacitor and cylindrical capacitor. Okay, in the next lecture we will see the series and parallel combination of the capacitors. Clear? Okay.